dawn. He says, he starts with the word, beautiful word, radiant one. Radiant one means, O enlightened one. O Bhairavi. Radiating means, who has got and who is able to share. Who is having and who is able to share. There is a big difference between a mystic and a master. Mystic is a person who achieved experience. Master is a person, not only you achieve, who can share the technology with others. Here, Shiva is addressing Devi as a radiant one who is radiating enlightenment. Not only she has experienced it, she can share with others. Enlightened master is speaking to another enlightened master. That is why this book is the essence of enlightenment. Not even a single word is unnecessary word. To tell you honestly, you can edit Brahma Sutra. You can edit Yoga Sutra. You can edit Gita. When I spoke on Yoga Sutra, I spoke only on 10 verses. Because essence is only 10. When I spoke on Brahma Sutra, I spoke only on 3 verses. Because essence is only 3. Brahma Sutra has got 555 sutras. I chose only 3 and spoke on that. Gita has got 700 slokas. I chose only 120 and spoke on that. Again, Yoga Sutra has got 555 sutras. I spoke only on 10 to 12 essence. But when I decided to speak on Shiva Sutra, I am not able to remove a single word. I am going to speak on all 112 sutras. Because I am not able to edit. I am not able to take out that this is the juice, this is the essence. No. Every single word is essence. You can't edit a single word. Now I am going to speak on all 112 sutras. Because you can't edit. He has spoken, he has expressed with minimum words the ultimate truth. You can't edit further. Now, let's start. O radiant one, this experience may dawn between two breaths. After breath comes in and just before turning up the beneficence. He says, the enlightenment, the Shiva consciousness can happen to you if you can go deep into the space where the breath is taking turn from out to in or in to out, up to down or down to up. It looks very simple. He's talking about your breath. He says, you can experience the Shiva consciousness between the space of two breaths. First, let us understand something about breath. From the moment of your birth to death, the one and only thing which you do without any discontinuity is breathing. Anything else can be stopped. You may be a child, or you may be young man, or you may become old, or you may fall sick, you may eat, you may sleep, you may not sleep, but you cannot stop breathing. That's a basic thing of life. Breathing is the one and only activity which you are doing continuously. Your being is made out of 5 elements. Earth, Prithvi, earth element, your bone and the base structure is made out of earth element. Next, water, you know, your blood and so many other things. in your system. Water element represents the water element energy. Next, fire, which is constantly burning in your manipurada, which is digesting all the food. We call it Vaishvanara Agni. Vaishvanara, the Agni which is inside your manipurada. Krishna says, Aham Vaishvanaro Bhutva Praninam Deham Asritaha Pranavana Samayukta Pachamyannan Chaturvitam. I am residing in every jiva, every being, as the fire. He is the fire. The fire element. If this fire goes away, your body has to be put in the fire. As long as this fire is alive, you will be alive. If this fire goes away, you have to put your body in the fire. Fire element. Next is air. Breath. Prana. Breath element. The air element. The fifth is ether. Ether is your mind, where your visualizations are happening, where your thinking is happening. That space is ether. Five space, five elements are there. And Tantra says, if you can directly work with the subtlest element, you will achieve enlightenment immediately. Working with earth means, then you have to move to the water, then you have to move to the fire, then you have to move to the air, from there you have to move to the ether. You have to move from one step to next. You can see, one will be subtler than the other. If you go deep, it will be subtler, subtler and subtlest. The earth and the water will have form, and the fire is formless form. Air and the ether will not have form. Fire can lead from form to formlessness. These are the five elements. If you can work with the subtlest, straight away you can become enlightened. You can reach the cosmic energy. You can reach the Atman. Taittiriya Upanishad says beautifully, Akasha Atmana, Atmana, from Atman comes the Akasha, from Akasha comes the Vayu, from Vayu, Vayu Rapa, from Vayu comes the Agni, from Agni comes the water, from water element comes the Prithvi, earth. If you can work with the subtlest element, straight away you can reach the enlightenment, the inner space. Here the subtlest element is Akasha, ether. But the big difficulty is you cannot directly work with ether. You cannot directly work with ether. You cannot directly work with your mind. The more you try to work with your mind, you may create suppressions and more difficulties. That's the reason Shiva is straight away working with air, little less subtle, but which is practical. Shiva is creating these techniques for human beings on the planet Earth who lived, who are living, and who is yet to come. He is creating techniques for all kinds of human beings. As I was telling you yesterday, sometimes I myself create questions and give answer, because people are not even that much intelligent to put intelligent questions. People are putting the questions only out of violence. They don't put out of innocence. Questions asked out of innocence are worth answering. Questions asked out of violence can neither be answered nor it is useful to answer. Let it be very clear. Sometimes people are not even that much intelligent to put the right question. So I need to design the question and give the answer, so that it is recorded for future. Same way here, Shiva is creating techniques which will be useful, which can be helped which can be of help not only for the present human beings, even for the people who are going to come. And he says, radiant on this experience made on between two breaths, after the breath comes in and just before turning up. One more thing. Directly or indirectly, you wanted to create that space which you will experience. Here, the technique itself directly sometimes may not give you the experience. But when your mind is engaged in the technique, the experience will start happening as a byproduct. The experience will start happening as a byproduct. That is why he has created a foolproof system. That's why I say Shiva has created a foolproof system. The technique itself may not directly give you the experience. A small story. One lady went to the grocery store and asked the person to give cat food for husband. He said, no, no, you can't give cat food for husband. He will die. She said, no, no, for last 1 week I am giving cat food only for his lunch and he is enjoying it. You give me. Every day she comes and picks up cat food. This guy is shocked and surprised. Anyhow, after a week, this grocer happened to browse the obituary column in the local newspaper and he saw the guy is dead. The woman's husband is dead. Next day when she came to the store, he said, I told you, don't give cat food. See, he is dead. She said, no, no, no. He is not dead because of the cat food. He is dead because he broke his neck trying to lick his body all over. When he tried to lick his body all over, he broke his neck and died. Directly or indirectly, what has to happen? Has happened. Let me be very clear. These techniques also, directly or indirectly, it will give you the experience. It will give you. Logically, you can't understand how the cat food can kill husband. How can the cat food kill the husband? You may not understand logically, but that is what happens. Whether you understand logically or not, it happens. Sometimes things happen directly, sometimes indirectly. Here, you may have a question, how can I become enlightened? Just by watching my breath. How can I become enlightened? Just by going into the space where my breath is taking turn. How enlightenment is possible? Logically, you may not understand, but when you go deep, it happens. It happens.